Hey everyone, this is Dan Thompson with Wise Money Tools. Thanks for joining me. Well, right now we are in the throes of another presidential election. That's always fun, right? It never fails, well, at least in my lifetime, and I'm kind of an old dude, that two of the most popular agenda items in every campaign seems to be taxes and energy. Well, in this particular election, we've got Donald Trump suggesting that we should lower taxes and keep our energy independence and the production of energy, and that's the way we should be going. And in the other corner, we have Joe Biden telling us that he wants to raise taxes, especially on corporations and the so-called rich, and then reduce and eventually eliminate our energy production and become totally energy free, at least when it comes to gas and oil. Well, Biden says he wants to tax the rich, those making over $400,000 a year, and corporations. Well, there's a few facts that I think we need to talk about, and then I'll have a little kind of a quiz for you, or maybe your opinion, and see what you think at the end. First off, let's look at corporations. I've said this in other videos, but it's worth revisiting again. Corporations are in existence for one reason. Can you guess at that what that is? It's to generate a profit. In fact, I'd say really every business, big or small, corporation, LLC, their overall objective is to create a profit. Corporations, however, have an additional drive to create this profit, and they're called shareholders. See, shareholders are really investors. And what they've done is they've invested their money, they paid for shares in the company in hopes, or should I say, in expectation that they're going to get a return on their money. Now, many of these corporations are even owned by you. If you have a 401k or own mutual funds, you likely own shares in a lot of these corporations. And when they're growing and they're making profits, that increases the value of your shares. And that could translate down to your retirement plans. You may not even realize it, but the working and the middle class rely on corporations for either their employment or for the profits to help them build their retirement accounts. A productive economy is not just for the rich, although you would think by listening to some of these politicians that these evil corporations must be taxed at even higher rates. So what is the result of these taxes? You kind of need to get a little background on how these corporations work, because corporations don't pay for anything. They don't pay for the materials to make their products. They don't pay for the machines they need to assemble their products. They don't pay for the management of the company. They don't pay for the employees of the company. They don't pay for the buildings, the maintenance, and the upkeep of the buildings. They don't pay for the electricity and the other utilities needed to run the business. And they don't pay the taxes assessed to the corporation. So in short, corporations really don't pay for anything. And then you say, well, Dan, then who does? Well, the simple answer is this: you do, I do, we all do. If you buy a product or a service from a company, you're paying in part for every cost and expense that they needed to spend in order to produce that product or service. Let's say that the product you just bought costs $100. What happens is that $100 is split between all the expenses that we listed earlier that's needed to make that product, including the taxes. What the bean counters did is they tallied up all the costs and expenses and the taxes that would have to be paid, and then they marked it up to also include a profit. Now, a profit is not just for the company and its employees, but as I mentioned earlier, it's also for its shareholders. Again, if you have a 401k, an IRA, mutual funds, that profit is likely benefiting you. Okay, so Mr. Biden says he's going to raise taxes on corporations, and again, those making $400,000 or more per year. So why should you care? You may not be in that income tax bracket. Well, if they tax the rich corporations, it's not going to affect you, right? Well, what if I told you that it would? Why would taxing a corporation cost you money. Let's just say Walmart. They make $1 billion in profit. And Biden says, we're going to take 10% more from Walmart and corporations like them. And so that's 10% less profit that the company's going to have. That's $100 million. Now remember, this profit goes to every shareholder, which again could be you. If you're Walmart and you're in charge, and you have the obligation to both your consumer and your shareholders, were you just going to say, well, that's a great thing. We love paying taxes and we're going to make less money. Probably not. So they're going to have to make up for that $100 million that Biden just took from them. So how are they going to do that? You got it. They're going to be forced to raise the prices on the products they sell. Now, we're not going to get into too deep in the weeds here, but if they raise prices 10%, that too is taxed. So it's an additional sales tax on top of that. So they actually have to raise their prices 12% so that they can actually pay the tax of 10% recovered. I know, a little deep in the weeds. Anyway, that 10% that Biden took from the corporations is going to cost you between 12 and maybe even as much as 15%, depending on your tax bracket and what state you live in. Now, you might well say, well, the rich are going to pay the higher prices too, and you might be right. But here's the catch. Did you know that the average working person spends 98% of his or her income, while the wealthy, they spend roughly 60% of their income? You know, I often hear from politicians that they care so much for the poor and the middle class, and I really would like to see them act like it at some point. They seem to be more concerned in how to stick it to the rich than the consequences it has on the poor. See, taxing corporations is a way to shift the tax burden to the middle and lower class eventually, but it's a roundabout way to do it. Right now, campaign speeches talk about a living wage, and somehow someone pulled a rabbit out of the hat and pegged $15 an hour as the minimum wage that supposedly everyone can live on. Well, let's use that for our example. Let's say you're making $15 an hour, working 40 hours a week, 4.3 weeks in a month. That's going to bring you $2,580 a month. Now, this wage earning group will not pay income taxes at all. Now, they'd still pay Social Security taxes, which is roughly 7%. So that's $180 out of their monthly paycheck. So their take home is going to be right around $2,400. Now, as I said, statistically, the working wage earner spends 98% of their income, which means their cost of living each month is $2,350. This is for their rent or mortgage, food, gas, utilities, clothes, everything else one needs just to get by. That might leave them at the end of the month somewhere between 80 and 100 bucks to spare. Now, suppose Biden gets in, and the first thing he wants to do is raise taxes on all the corporations and anyone making over $400,000 a year. Every corporation and every business owner is going to have to make some decisions. They can do one of several things. Number one, they can do their work and run their business with fewer employees, cut some costs. What's that going to do? That's going to lead to higher unemployment. Maybe they can replace several workers with a machine. Maybe it wasn't so cost effective to do that before, but now the trade-off for higher taxes might make it feasible. Number two, they could also reduce benefits or just lower wages for everybody that works there. They could also increase the price of all their goods and services to compensate for the extra cost. They might be able to reduce the quality of their products and cut corners as well. And finally, they can eat the cost of the additional tax in their profits, which will take profit from the shareholders, and eventually the price of the stock's going to go down, and all those who have 401ks and mutual funds are not going to be too happy because the value of their shares are going to be dropping. Those preparing and saving for retirement, mainly, again, the middle class, they're going to feel the brunt of it. No matter how the corporation handles the taxes, it's ultimately going to be bad for the consumer, and that's you and me. Why? Because we're going to pay for it. Our unemployment numbers are either going to go up, our price of goods are going to go up, our retirement plans are going to pay for it, all of which trickles down to us. Now, suppose the corporations choose to increase prices. That seems like the easiest thing to do. They'd like to keep their employees and keep the shareholders and the retirement funds profitable. So these corporations, where our hard-working wage earners are, who have to buy groceries, gas for their car, the car itself, clothes, appliances, utilities, the internet, phone, and so on, they're all going to get raised prices. And let's just say it's going to be 15% to compensate for the added tax burden put on the corporations. So now our family that spends $2,350 now to live each month just had a cost of living increase of $282. Now their cost of living is $2,632 a month. Well, let's look at this annually. So again, they're making $28,800. They're currently spending $28,200 to live. They might have an extra $600 in the year's time to do some other things with it. But if they get a 15% cost of living increase, their annual needs are going to go to $33,120, more than they make. Now they're underwater. They're spending almost $400 more because their cost of living increased. Even the $15 so-called living wage really didn't help them. They're going to be in the hole each month and now are potentially going to be candidates for food stamps and welfare. Do you know how food stamps and welfare are paid? They're paid for by our taxes. So as more and more families get on government subsidies or programs, well, guess what? They're going to have to raise taxes again to compensate for the new rolls of welfare and food stamps. So this thing just gets worse and worse. So did taxing the rich and the filthy corporations really help the hardworking families? Well, let's kind of find out. We're going to define four income classes: the rich, the upper middle class, the lower middle class, and then our current family that we've been talking about, we'll call the wage earners. So the rich, let's say the rich are identified as those making over $200,000 a year. And as we pointed out, the average spends 60% of their income, or in this case, $120,000. So they still have $80,000 left that they can save or invest. If their cost of living went up 15%, they would now have to spend $138,000. Now, something they're not really too excited about, obviously, but they can still save and invest $62,000. Now let's talk about the upper middle class, who make about $100,000 a year. They spend on average 80% of their income, or in this case, $80,000 after all for all their expenses. So they can still, at the end of the day, save or invest $20,000 per year. If their cost of living went up 15%, they would now have to spend $115,000 a year. That's a bigger bite out of their income, and now they can only save or invest about $5,000 instead of $20,000. That other $15,000 went to taxes. That's a pretty big hit. Now, the lower middle class, these people make about $50,000 a year, but they spend 95% of their income, which in this case is $47,500. They only have an extra $2,500 a year to save or invest. If their cost of living goes up 15%, they would now need to spend $51,650 to meet their monthly expenses. Now, that class is underwater. They're going backwards. They have a higher cost of living than they're making in wages. Well, then lastly, let's go to our wage earners, our $15 an hour earners. We already know they were underwater and going into the hole each month, but now what we've realized is that the lower and middle class are now going underwater with them. Neither of these two classes have enough extra money, or what I call discretionary income, to financially survive the cost due to the heavier tax burdens put on corporations. So here's the $100,000 question. Did the rich or the poor really get hurt by raising corporate taxes and effectively trickling those costs down to you and I? See, these politicians really don't think through these things. They're not economists. These politicians have no idea how business works. Most of them have never been in business. They think if they raise taxes 10% on corporations, that these corporations are simply going to go to their bank account and pay it, that nothing changes, that these taxes can be raised in a vacuum and it won't affect anybody. It's a fallacy, and one that sadly too many politicians prey upon. The politicians want to get you upset and vilify the rich and let's go stick it to them. But in the end, those that agree with the politicians and vote them into office end up sticking it to themselves. See, the lower and middle class and below are already in a zero tax bracket. No one's going to raise their taxes. No one's even talking about it. But they're going to get hit with a tax anyway. It's called a cost of living tax. It's a silent tax. You may not even notice it, just a few dollars here and there. But it will eventually eat up the lower middle class and the wage earners. If your cost of living goes up because taxes went up on the corporations that you buy stuff from, you're going to feel it and pay for it at some point. Now the corporation, maybe they just are going to lay off employees. But if that's you, now this whole tax raising scheme is even worse. So that's it for this discussion. We've got a couple more facts about this tax raising idea that you're going to want to know about. In the meantime, if you have any questions, shoot them to questions@wisemoneytools.com. I'll answer them just as quick as I can. If you have any comments, feel free to put them below. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you ever want to have a strategy session where we talk about your situation, click on the time trade link below. Well, that's it. Good to see you. Talk to you next week. Take care.